Hello, welcome to the Vector Garden YouTube channel. In this video, we're going to take a look at mandalas, which you can, of course, create using the plugin MirrorMe, as I have done here in this file. You can use the repeat function to create mandalas, but there's also a third method to create them, and we're going to look at that one. The other method uses transform effects, and to do so, we are going to prepare something in that file. We're going to take the polar grid tool and make a pattern, and I'm going to remove these rings, and I'm going to increase the number of parts on this one. So we've got 12 parts here, and this is our guide that we're going to use. And now I'm going to take the direct selection tool and select these two lines and copy them. And then what we can do is go to the layers panel and just lock this layer, create a new one and paste in place. I've used the shortcut for that, which is Command F or Control F on Windows. Like so. So I'm going to unlock this one more time and select it and just set the lines to a lighter color. Let's make them blue, like so, and let's lock them. So next thing is I'm going to just enlarge this here and like so, and move these, and I'm using smart guides to align that, so the smart guides highlight this here, that this all fits in place. And now we're going to take the pen tool and connect the two, and this is now one path. Let's go in here, and you see this is one path. And what we need to do is draw our pattern inside of this here. So we're going to make this a clipping mask, and this will be a special clipping mask because we want to just draw. And in order to be able to just draw in Illustrator, the clipping mask needs to be applied to the layer. So you just highlight this layer here and hit this button here. So this creates a clipping mask. And we can also lock this clipping mask. And now what we need to do to further prepare this, we're going to target this layer, and then we need to apply some effects to this. So I need to unlock this in order to be able to target this layer. Just click on the target symbol and then go to Window Appearance. The Appearance panel is already here. And here the layer is now targeted, and we are going to apply effect, distort and transform, and there's the transform effect. And first of all, we need to mirror this. So we need to set the origin for this, which is down here, the bottom left, and then this needs to be reflected, and we need one copy like so. And this is done. And we need another one. So let's go to Effect Transform. And Illustrator warns us, but we really want a new effect. You need to take away this. And now we need six copies. And then set the origin here and rotate them by 60 degrees. And it's not six, it's five copies. So in summed up, we have six parts, and let's go to OK. So this is this, and now I can lock my mask and just take the brush tool and select a color, and then let's draw in here, like so. This is great. What's important here? We have the appearance panel here. Go into the layer, and you have to have this option, new art has basic appearance. This needs to be checked so that the paths themselves don't get the same appearance. So they shouldn't get the effects. And now we can draw. But what happens if we draw like so? And you see this all shifts to the side. This happens because the bounding box includes the things that are actually masked, but they are larger than the mask, and this gets now ignored. So the trouble is that this doesn't quite work. We need another reference object on this. So I'm going in here and select the ellipse tool and zoom out a little, and I need to hit the center of this object here, and then with Option and Shift dragged, I'm drawing a rather large circle, like so. So this is large, this circle, and it doesn't need a stroke. It's just there. Let's move it down here. And now, of course, you see the effects lead to complete distortion because the reference points don't match anymore. So what do? We target the layer again and go into the first transform effect, and we need to set this to the center, like so. It's the center of the circle. The circle is the largest element. And then we need to go into the second one as well and set this to the center as well. Both are in the center of the circle, like so. And you see, now it fits. And it doesn't matter if the objects are larger than the mask. We just draw and then change this. Now you might ask, what's the advantage compared to MirrorMe? MirrorMe is free, so you can just download it and use it. The advantage is that using transform effects, you can create a vast array of different transforms and copies that go beyond mandalas. And you can see a glimpse into that when you take a look at the templates of matte pattern. These patterns help you to design patterns based on the 17 methods of tessellation. So in them, the makers use transform effects and clipping mask, and basically the method we just use to create the mandala. So this is how matte pattern works. This is how transform effects work. And then happy creating.